Harold Green, maybe not as fit as he was a week ago after the week off, but he's still taking it pretty well, and he's been riddled by some nagging injuries this season. First and 10 at the 49. Two men to the right, Ellis looking that way, and gambling, Deion Sanders almost took that one back for six.
I want you to watch number two. They say he has tremendous closing speed. He'll play off, but he'll come up fast. Watch how quick this guy runs. Look at that. If that ball was on the mark, it might have been intercepted. I'm surprised. It's man coverage. They go right after everybody's All-American Deion Sanders. That's confidence in Ellis, but I don't know if it's wise.
Maybe the last time you see that pass tonight. Trent Simpson is in there. Ryan Harris, also in a tight end position. The ball is crumbled at midfield, and the Seminoles have it. Kelvin Smith, 36. Harold Green on the turnover. Deion Sanders leads his teammates off the field after the turnover.
Well, Harold Green never did have this ball. He kicks it right there on the handoff, and now it's loose. Just a matter of where it ends up, and it ends up in Florida State's hands.
The early part of the game will be a key for Peter Tom Willis, a 6'3 junior quarterback for Florida State. He is expected to be pressured all night long. To the deep man, that's Chris Barker, a 6-foot freshman. Let's meet the Seminoles offensively. With Ferguson injured, they go with junior Peter Tom Willis at quarterback. Fullback Dane Williams is very good in short yardage. The tailback, freshman Chris Barker. Juniors Juana Lewis and Terry Anthony follow in a long line of great FSU wide receivers. Senior Tom O'Malley, the start at tight end. Michael Tanks tries to anchor center, a problem position this year. The guards, Tony Yeomans and Jason Pipers. Head tackle, seniors Joey Iannotta and All-American Pat Tomberlin, one of the Seminoles' best ever on the offensive line. They got six on first down. Willis with time. Long to the end zone. And a score to Terry Anthony. 44 yards, and the visiting team takes the lead 2.5 minutes in. Of the year, and it's 7-0 Seminoles, as the crowd for the moment in Columbia is very shocked.